So let's move on to the next question, which is there any indication blood type influences COVID-19 risk? So based on some very small studies, just very limited evidence, there is some indication that people with blood group A may have a higher risk of acquiring COVID-19 compared to non-A blood groups, whereas individuals with blood type O may have a lower risk of the infection compared to non-O blood groups. So ABO blood groups have been involved in the susceptibility to other viral infections. In the related SARS-CoV-1 virus, type A antibodies, as found in people with type O or type B blood types, can provide protection by inhibiting the interaction of the virus with the ACE2 receptor. So first, blood type is a classification of blood based on the presence or absence of antibodies, as well as inherited antigenic substances on the surface of red blood cells. One of the most important blood type systems is the ABO system, and it's important to understand that the ABO, so type A, type B, type O, or AB, is the most dominant antigen. So this is the signal that evokes an immune response that is present in blood cells. This antigen type is essentially just a modified sugar. So people with type A blood have a type A antigen on the surface of their cells, which means they make antibodies against antigens that are type B, because this is recognized as not self. This is why a person with type A blood will reject a blood transfusion with a type B blood type due to immune response. So the body makes type B antibodies to attack that antigen and vice versa. A person with type O blood, which is, I think it's the most common, does not express either A or B antigen. Therefore, they make antibodies against both A and B antigens, since they are both considered foreign. This means that people with type O blood can donate blood to a person with any blood type, since their blood cells do not express either A or B antigen. It will not elicit an immune response. But they can only receive blood from a person with type O, since they make antibodies against A and B antigens. So again, this very preliminary data suggests that people with type O blood may be less susceptible to COVID-19 because they produce the type A antibodies, which are possibly inhibiting the interaction between SARS-CoV-2 and the ACE2 receptor. Now, that has been shown to be the case for SARS-CoV-1. In one study investigating the relationship between ABO blood group and the COVID-19 susceptibility, it was found that people with blood group A have a higher risk for acquiring COVID-19 compared to non-A blood groups, whereas blood groups O have a significantly lower risk for the infection compared to non-O blood groups. Another study, a retrospective analysis from clinical features in 101 death cases with COVID-19, the ABO blood group distribution of deaths differed pretty remarkably between that from the Han population in Wuhan. Although not analyzed statistically, type O was comparatively low, while type A was high. It's possible that some of the protection for type O blood groups and some of the increased risk for the type A blood groups may be similar to the mechanisms that have been seen with SARS-CoV-1, namely the fact that type A antibodies have been shown to provide protection by inhibiting the interaction between the SARS-CoV-1 virus and the ACE2 receptor, which is how the virus gets entry into the cell.